everyone. I hope you are doing well. Well, I do still have a big beard. Every couple months, but since I started doing that, I have had quite a bit less of the split ends. Just is try and trim as little off the ends as possible. Best if I try and keep her on my lap, because otherwise she's roaming around, rubbing her face on the camera tripod and the microphone stand. I generally measure just from the front of the chin, not really like the bottom, but the front, just the front, like where you would imagine if someone has, you know, one of those little butt chins where the little dimple on the chin is. So we'll start with length in inches. Everyone knows once you get above 7 inches, it's no longer that relevant to start looking at partial inches. So we'll just call it 8, even though it's, you know, a little bit more. Okay, so next, I'm going to measure is about 8 inches, so I've got a 8 by 8 square. Okay, so now let's measure the girth, I suppose. I feel like the girth should be measured up close to the chin. So my beard is 8 inches long, 8 inches wide, and then when smushed together, 2 inches around. It's fairly big, in my opinion. Clock. self-consciousness about my hair there. Whatever. A classic for my beard videos on dropper. Beard oil. I do have a tendency to over oil my beard on these videos. So, if you're curious about beard care, generally just a couple drops. Watching a video recently where someone was using one of these droppers, and it just reminded me how much I love the sounds they make. Finer toothed side of the comb. feels really good to have my beard combed. I actually really like it when someone I'm comfortable with combs or plays with my beard. Just as a side note, make sure you ask someone before you touch their beard. Unfortunately, I've had quite a few people touch my beard and then ask me if it's okay. Smells of sandalwood, because that is the smell of the beard oil. Sometimes the beard oil being like on my mustache or my beard can be quite potent. So that's again another reason why a little bit goes a long way, so that you're not overpowered by, like in this case, sandalwood. So I've got a couple of rune beard beads here. We've got the rune of protection. Then take one of the sections, split it into three fairly even pieces. Side here. I'm going to do the tear rune, the rune of strength, named for the god. Is present in many of the other pagan pantheons of old Germanic Europe, beyond just the Scandinavian Viking. Okay, so we'll just go ahead and start braiding this side. Oops. Trying to get close to the microphone, but not bump it like that. Braiding. And the angle over here is more difficult than on the other side. And over here I will do the algae's rune, the rune of protection. Sedge. Which I believe is a plant associated with an elk. But it is the rune of protection. Can be applied to physical protection. It's especially known for its more protection from dark forces, spiritual, or protection of the soul, almost. So, I took my big beard and I tamed it, so to speak. was interesting. Quite often when I do dual braids, I like to actually just do them like they're coming off the mustache. I mean, that's not what's happening, but that's kind of what it looks like. Leave the rest of the beard filled in. But like, if I have something on my t-shirt that I want to be able to be seen, because normally my beard is like covering whatever's on the t-shirt, this is a good way to do that. Because it, first of all, shortens the beard a little bit because of the braiding, hinge braid, you know. They hold each other, so it actually shortens it up a bit. And then also leaves the middle spot open so it can be seen through. So, yeah. One thing I have noticed too is I don't like to braid my hair and my beard at the same time. I feel like there's can be too much braiding going on, although